Hi, I'm Don with AWS.
Hi, I'm Vijay from Peloton, and this is my architecture.
So Vijay, as an active rider, had a Peloton for about 6 years. Really excited to talk about your architecture that you have here today, the recommendations that I've always wondered, you know, how do you know what I like? I'd love to learn more.
As you may know, Peloton is the leading connected fitness company that currently has over 8 platforms where members actually can take workouts at the convenience of their home. We have over 6.5 million members today. We have had over 1 billion workouts on the platform, so we know a lot about our members and their preferences, and we typically use a lot of that information to power their experiences on the platform itself. In order to do that, today we actually build large-scale recommender systems that are powering a lot of the personalization experience that you see on the platform today.
So across those 8 platforms, I have to imagine the recommendations are very different based on data and the frequency of the data and the frequency of the rides, if you will. Can you walk us through the model training, what goes on behind the scenes to actually prepare the data?
Sure. So today, we train our models once a day. That is done in an offline batch process where we take a lot of our historical data that we know about our members, which is currently stored on S3. We take that data, we pre-process that data and using Amazon EMR clusters, which runs Spark Jobs. Once we pre-process the data, we use that data to actually train our models itself, which is again run on an EKS cluster, which hosts some of our GPU instances. Once we train these models and we are comfortable with the performance of those models, we actually push those models into our model registry, which stores the model artifacts itself. Mm.
And do you use anything for ML ops or anything behind the scenes to manage that flow?
So we do, and we currently, all our jobs are orchestrated using Airflow that is actually managed on MWA, okay, which is again a managed AWS service.
Great. And as far as the data that you have, I see a graph database and we have DynamoDB with a feature store. Can you talk about the data and how you process that?
In order to support our real-time inference, we have a couple of low latency data stores that support our inference in real-time. The two of them that you're seeing here, one of them is the graph database, as well as the Amazon DynamoDB, which actually hosts all our features that are necessary for scoring our models. These stores are actually powered by EMR jobs that are run that populate all the historical information that is necessary for scoring the models itself. So both these stores are actually populated using the Spark jobs that are run on EMR clusters.
Okay, and just, you know, from my understanding, what type of data are we talking about? What's in the graph? What's in the feature store?
Sure. So the graph hosts a lot of the information about the members, as well as the rides that they have taken on the platform. So if you have taken a class recently on the platform on the bike, that becomes an edge on our graph database. We leverage that information a lot of the times to power a list of candidates that is necessary for scoring the models itself. Now, in terms of the feature store, as you are aware, the machine learning models need a lot of the data that is pre-processed in a way that can be used to score our models as well as train the models. The feature store hosts a lot of that information. Some of them includes historical information about your behaviors on the platform, the instructors that you might like, the durations that you might like, or the fitness disciplines that you might like. All of that is basically stored in our feature store.
Great. That's super helpful. I know as a rider, when I come in and you know exactly which instructor, the length, the type of music I like, that's very helpful. Time saving. So let's walk from the perspective of the bike, right? So if you could describe kind of what's on the bike and then how you're interacting with the hydration service and the rest of the services here.
So when somebody tries to get on the bike and start a workout on the bike, the call comes to a backend service, which we are calling that as a hydration service that is typically used to hydrate the recommendations. The hydration service calls our recommendation service, where you can think of this service as an orchestrator service.
Okay.
That typically orchestrates all the information that is necessary to generate the recommendations itself. So for example, it makes a call to the feature store to fetch all the features that are necessary for this member. It also fetches a list of candidates from the graph store itself.
Okay.
That is necessary to populate the recommendations. It also fetches the latest model that is necessary and to score the recommendations itself. All of that information is now passed to the inference service, which takes in all the information, scores the model against all those candidates that we have fetched, and then returns a list of scored classes that the recommendation service can actually now return back to the hydration service. Once the hydration service receives the recommendations, then the hydration service sends the recommendations back.
Okay. And then MSK, event logging, what events are being emitted and what do you do with those events?
The recommendation service, which is the orchestrator service, fetches all the information before it sends the recommendations back to the hydration service. It logs a lot of the information and we use a lot of this information for our training purposes. So this gets stored into S3. Which is further used for training our models.
Okay, so that becomes a feedback loop for the entire system. Well, thank you, Vijay. I really appreciate you sharing your architecture today.